Let's get into Saudi Arabia and Crown Jewel. Because
Crown Jewel.
This whole thing is ridiculous. Yeah,
there's a lot of controversy on
this
one.
The RKJ man sent Eric and I something today that said that WWE is going to go on with the event. So we're going to act like the event's going to go on. Whether it gets canceled before our next podcast, that doesn't matter to the point.
That's their deal.
We're going to act like it's going to go on. So
the event's going on.
We're going to discuss it. But before we discuss it, we are all going to give our opinions on what we think about WWE going to this event and what we think this event means and all this
and
stuff.
And the superstars around it.
Exactly. So who wants to go first? Who wants to give their opinion
first? Well, I know the RKJ man wants to
He always wants to give his opinion.
You know I got always got something to say. Always
You've been
got
holding
something
this up for quite a while now.
Yeah,
so
exactly.
No, I'm just saying that, you know, we all knew that this was going to happen. You know, we knew that the WWE had gotten a crap ton of money from Saudi Arabia. And so when this thing went down, we were like, well, in the words of, I hate to bother, Demi Lovato, sorry, but not sorry. Sorry, but not sorry.
I thought you were going to say like a song from Kanye West.
No, man. Like, you know, but in the words of Kanye West, WWE, how can you be so heartless, man?
I mean,
at the end of the day, when it comes down to it, money is king. Cash rules everything around me.
Money talks.
Get the money. Dollars out of the bills, y'all. That's
Wu-Tang Clan.
Wu-Tang Clan. Yeah. But I think at the end of the day, we knew this was going to happen. There is absolutely positively no reason for us to just continue dwelling on this. Do I think it's BS? Absolutely. Of course I think it's BS. But it's business. And at the end of the day, as we see, just because it's business doesn't mean it's always the best thing ethically, you know. So at the end of the day, when it comes down to it, WWE made the decision. They got a crap ton of money from this. I'm just more disappointed in the superstars who spoke out and aren't going to back up their roles. John Cena and Daniel Bryan allegedly are refusing to go. Now, allegedly now it's getting to the point where John Cena has totally said he's not going. But John Cena and Daniel Bryan were on the first ever event in Saudi Arabia. They were in that Greatest Royal Rumble. So they didn't have a problem taking Saudi Arabia's money back then, you know, when things were when they knew about sketchy things going on in that time during that era too. So what's changed now? Okay, well, one journalist got killed, and I'm sorry about that. That's absolutely terrible to hear that, but really? You didn't have that stance and you couldn't make a stance and a stand during that time? That's the reason why I got on Corey Graves, because I think he was being a hypocrite going to Saudi Arabia, taking the money, taking the advance, and then after that coming back, getting in the confines on his phone and social media, drinking a crappy IPA and going off about the freedoms that you have. Okay, I can respect that, but where were you a few months ago? When you could have said, hey, look, I'm not going to this event. I don't care how much money you guys are paying me for. I'm going to take a stand for what I believe in.
Yeah, no, I mean, I like that you're calling out those guys, too, a guy like Cena, too, because, you know, Cena has a good image, and Daniel Bryan has a good image. We were just discussing that in a way. But you're right. Daniel Bryan's on a show about women on
Total
reality show, Total Bellas, two shows actually.
Total Divas,
Total Bellas.
Yeah, and same he thing. Also has a wife that's outspoken about women's issues, and has a daughter,
and a sister-in-law.
Yeah,
and
so
Nikki Bella.
He was going to go to the event before James Khashoggi got murdered. Okay, and we don't know if the government actually did it. They're claiming they didn't do it, and even our U.S. government is really pressuring them to you know. And it's just a lot of shit going on. We're not gonna get into all that.
Yeah,
but
we're not gonna get into
we all
politics.
Know someone was. This guy was killed, and there's a lot of evidence, and there's a lot of rumors pointing to a sketchy Saudi Arabian government who's done shit like this in the past.
And let's not forget also that they don't like homosexuals.
Yeah,
they don't like women.
Well, it's not that they don't like women. They don't give women the same respect
it's not
as they
the
do
same
men.
Rights,
they don't give the same rights as men. They, you know, they've been outspoken against certain religions, if I'm not mistaken, like Christianity.
Absolutely. Yeah,
like
no,
Christianity. And Shawn Michaels is a Christian man, a born-again Christian.
Come on, Shawn.
And D-Generation X. Speaking of which, did y'all see Shawn Michaels trying to run on Raw this past week as Degeneration X.
I hope that's not a sign of what we're going
to
see.
That man was blown up, just running to the ring. He was just like, you can see this body. He's like, man, I don't think I can do this shit like I used to anymore. But that money's too good.
His hair couldn't do it like he used to be. No, right?
He's bald. That motherfucker's bald.
It's like scary watching. Like Shawn Michaels looks a little like stiff. Like, and I'm just like, what the fuck, man?
But that's beside the point. It's just all these guys, and obviously Cena, you know, being the good guy he is, for him to initially, he did the event before and thanked all the fans. Uh-huh. Got on the
and
mic.
And now he's not going to do this.
Yeah.
He's not
going to
do
this. Now, allegedly,
he's not going to do this. Now, he's still announcing the World Cup tournament. When Kurt Angle did his
speech.
Is
it really World Cup?
Yeah. It's not
It's an WWE, or it's what I would call it is the WWE World Cup of guys that don't have a title. That's it's not the best. I mean, there is a lot of dope guys in this event. I mean, you have Rollins and Ziggler and Randy Orton.
Why not just bring back
Orton.
The King of the Ring term?
You know what it is, man. We all know what it is. It's a way to get top stars on the card so that the Saudi Arabian prince is happy.
Yeah.
Because he's giving them $40 to $50 million for this event.
A year. A event.
A show. Yeah, because I'm reading this thing on Forbes that says they had like $11.9 million. One 3 month period, and then they all of a sudden had 60, and so in the months where after Greatest Royal Rumble happened, so it's somewhere in the range of that, you know, minus cost of the wrestlers that they hired to go over. Because I've heard stuff like Chris Jericho got offered a shit ton to be at that event. Shawn Michaels must be getting
loaded.
About $8 million.
Yeah.
Oh, he's probably getting Brock Lesnar money for this event.
Yeah.
And you know, Undertaker, Triple H, they've all kind of had contracts and stuff. But like, so. You know, there's a lot of money, and money's money, right? And Shawn probably is going to leave $8 million on the table, right? To be a little blasphemous and go over there, right?
I mean, and it's hypocritical for me because I look at Shawn Michaels, a guy who is a Christian. I'm a Christian. I look at him, and I'm like, bro, they doing all this stuff, and they're firmly against our beliefs. You going over there for that money, man.
So,
and you know what the Bible says, man. What is it to gain the whole world and lose your whole soul, man? So the WWE is about to lose their soul just for a little bit of paper, man.
Selling your soul.
They're selling their soul, man. They just got a $2 billion deal from Fox.
So let's look at it this way, because I know you're a Christian, RKJ, man. If you were working for the company and then let's just say that they offered you a shit ton of money just to go to Saudi Arabia, would you still go?
No. Because sometimes you have to be able to look yourself in the mirror and be able to live with yourself.
Even if
the
they
next
offered
day.
You like a lot of money, but or they pressured
if I,
you.
If I was working for the WWE, I would assume that I'd already be making enough money financially, and I never want to be to the point where I have to completely, totally sell my soul for money. You know what I'm saying? Like, if you're in that point in your life, you've made a lot of mistakes and you fucked up in life.
Yeah.
Because if your life is to the point where you're just banking on WWE to come to you and say, hey, Saudi Arabia really wants you, we're going to put $6 million on the table, take it or leave it. And you gotta be like, okay, whatever, knowing the fact that Saudi Arabia was sketchy. And we know that Saudi Arabia was sketchy in years before. Now, they would have been trying to make efforts. And actually, there was a picture of The Rock, actually, with the Saudi Arabian prince. And a CNA reporter, CNN reporter.
Yeah, they called The Rock out. I was looking at something on Twitter. They called The Rock. And there's a lot of it's The Rock, Oprah, all these people that you would think have good standing with most people. They met with this dude because, you know, all the Saudi Arabian prince ain't no Hitler, and he's not Stalin, and he's not this terrible fucking dude.
Well, he's not like the Japanese,
but he's also
closed off the world to every himself off from the world.
Exactly, right. But he's also not I would not say like a good guy.
He's not,
right. He inherited this because his family. He wasn't voted by the people. Right. Yeah, he wasn't voted by the people of Saudi Arabia. He inherited this because he was born out of some woman's vagina. And that, I guess, made him the prince of Saudi Arabia. Like, that's the dumbest thing I've ever heard. But I'm not going to get into talking shit on the Saudi Arabian culture because you never know who's listening, right?
Right.
But ultimately, if you're from Saudi Arabia, you probably think the same shit. And that's why you cheered Carmella at that event last night. Right?
Yeah. Okay?
So, sorry to hit a promo in Saudi Arabia here, but, like, come on. So, I mean...
That was great.
They shouldn't be doing the event. There's a lot of selfish reasons why I don't think they should be doing the event. Number one, we're going to Survivor Series, and I'd much rather see all of these matches at Survivor Series.
And that
Series.
Pissed me off, man.
Yeah,
so, because now we're just going to get the bad.
No, they're just desperate.
I'm hoping Daniel Bryan doesn't go. I'm hoping John Cena is. Right. If Daniel Bryan doesn't go, that means we're having that WWE Championship match at our pay-per-view.
Look, that match between AJ Styles and Daniel Bryan, they are desperate to put him in the freaking Crown Jewel pay-per-view.
Yeah, no, I know. I'm looking
at that. That should have been Survivor Series pay-per-view.
Yeah, there's only five booked angles at this whole thing anyway.
Also, that's because they expect the World Cup to go along. Well, also, let's not forget that 5 days before this is WWE Evolution, an all-women's pay-per-view, y'all. An all-women's pay-per-view where the WWE is stressing equality. The women could do just as much as men. Right. Stephanie McMahon is coming out and having the audacity to say she wants the equal amount of men and women on the roster. No.
Come on. This is what's going to happen.
It's not going to happen. Women's wrestlers
WWE is just going to say, all right, let's just get on with this Evolution pay-per-view. Come on. Let's do this.
We can see it in the way y'all booking it, man.
Yeah, there's just like this rushing it.
Come on. Why do you have your biggest angle going into the first women's pay-per-view ever, a guy DDT his friend on the floor.